Clearly, over the 12 years, poor Eurystheus had grown tired of Heracles and his incessant victories. He was out of ideas on how to get rid of him, almost, except one, to send him to the damned depths of Hades, the realm of the dead. No one who entered Hades ever returned. Therefore, he was certain that even the son of Zeus would not return. So the 12th and most dangerous labor of Heracles was to travel to the underworld and bring back Cerberus. Cerberus was the famed three-headed, fire-breathing, serpent-tailed offspring of Echidna and Typhon that guarded the realm of Hades, preventing the souls of the dead and visitors who dared enter while still alive from ever leaving. Prior to his journey, Athena and Hermes guided Heracles on how to travel to the underworld while still alive, by preparing and versing him in the Eleusinian mysteries, while Hestia implored the undead ferryman, Charon, to ferry him across the Acheron River. When Heracles got to the underworld, he met Theseus and his friend, Pirithous, both of whom had been enslaved by Hades for attempting to abduct Persephone. He freed Theseus from the chair of forgetfulness he was bound, but when he tried to free Pirithous, the earth trembled so violently that Heracles was forced to leave him behind. Pirithous desired Persephone for himself, so he was doomed by the king of the dead to remain in the underworld for eternity. Thereafter, Heracles reached the throne of Hades, where he humbly asked the grim god to allow him temporarily take Cerberus to the surface world. Hades calmly responded that he could do as he wished, only if he could overpower the giant hound with his raw strength, doing no harm to it in the process. When Heracles found Cerberus, the two engaged in a terrible fight, and after quite a while of struggling and grunting and growling, the hero managed to subdue the hound. Lifting the massive Cerberus on his shoulders, Heracles headed out of the underworld into the land of the living, straight to the palace of Eurystheus. Now, when Eurystheus saw the hound of Hades, he fled into his large jar, terrified to death, crying and begging Heracles to take it away, promising to release him from any other labors. Thus, Cerberus returned to Hades, and Heracles was released by Eurystheus. He had served his penance, free to start a new life. It is claimed that he joined the Argonauts for a short while, in their quest for the Golden Fleece, thereafter. Heracles would go on to have many other great adventures, and by the time of his death, he would be rewarded with immortality, as promised, and reside on Olympus, where Hera would forgive him, granting him the hand of her daughter, Hebe, in marriage.